Hi everybody! Today there's another video with the stem set from Create a Smile, and I hope you like it. But first of all, I want to ask you, how did you like my new video intro? I made it on my own, and I'm a little bit proud of it, so if you like it, I would be very happy to have some comments from you. And now I talk to the card. Hello card. So, I started with masking all these bottles. I used for masking only noted paper. It's not the best way for masking, but for me it's totally enough to have this paper, because I'm very fast with it, and I can switch very fast between my points where I want to stamp it, and it's not so expensive. So I think I paid in euro 1 or 2 euros for a big pack of this paper, and for all my maskings it's very good. Yes, and if you did no masking ever, the important thing you need to know is the thing you stamp first is this, what you have in the foreground, and everything you stamp on the mask is in the background. So when I started masking, it was so hard for me to find this logical in my head or in my brain. But if you once have this trick understood, then it's so easy, and you can mask so fast, and you mask everything, can mask every scene you want to. For example, these bottles. Now comes the coloring. I used gray Copics, and I try to reach or to color the round shape of this bottle. And I do not even know what to talk about this Copic coloring, because Copic coloring you've seen in a lot of videos before, I think. But maybe to see me coloring bottles helps you for your next project. So I would not talk so much. I would love to give you some music, and I try to look for some new English words and see you back after the, or hear you back after the music. And the music starts now.
Thank you.
as you could see, I did two layers, because the color is more intensive if you have two layers, or more layers better, but I had too much bottles, or too many bottles. It was for a third layer I hadn't fun. So, but to keep it look like a real bottle, I tried out some greens, and I tried it on the side because I knew my bottles are brighter than my cardstock later. So I decided to use these two green colors. It's YG06 and G43. Maybe you have green tones which will fit better for these bottles. Maybe you can take a brown bottle or blue bottles. I decided for green because I think it's like, is it champagne? In German it's Sekt. So, and I just colored over all these bottles, and I was not afraid to come over the lines because I will cut it now. And for the finish I took my Zero Copic to make some glass shining on the bottles. So now my scissors come in action. I cut out these bottles near to the black line. And for hiding some cutting mistakes, I took my black Copic marker and colored the border, corner, what is it, the edge of this image. And now I create my background. For this I used my distress inks, and I think you have seen it in a lot of videos how to create this kind of background, so maybe you take this part of the video for relaxing a little bit. Maybe you are on a cross trainer, and so it's good that the video is very long so you get more fit maybe. So I took a kind of pinky red and blue in the background, and I want to have it very dark, so that is why I put my ink pad directly on the paper, but I think it was not so good idea. It was hard to blend this away. So, but then my background is nearly finished. I took some gray distress ink for the corners, and at least some yellow to make it a little bit sunset-y, oh, kind of sunset. So this is my background, and now as always I use some water drops and a paper towel to reach this great effect, and then I took some white and silver color and sprinkled it over my background. This was the whole magic. So I took black cardstock, cut my background that it's fit in the middle of this cardstock, and now I need some more. I need these. Oh, what is the English word? Wait, I have to look for it. Okay, stupid me. It's nearly like the German word. In German it's Korken, in English it's Kork, and the material would be Kork in German too. Okay, it's a Korken. I stamped a lot of them, and then I colored them brown. I can tell you the Copic numbers. Wait, it's E59, E57 and E35, and in the second round I used for a darker brown the E47, but it's not so much darker than the E59, but I mix these dark tones very often. Then I use my double-sided foam tape to glue these bottles on my card. And this is the first impression you have from this card, how it's gonna be look like. And I knew that it's to over the edge, so I cut it with my scissors. And I'm nearly ready now. Now comes these corks. Oh no, first the sentiment. I stamped it with Versafine and put some clear embossing powder over it. I think the sentiment is not so good readable, but it's okay for me. In real, it's looks a little bit better than now on the video. And now the corks find their places on the card. I haven't counted. If I have really for each bottle one cork. I made it that it's only look pretty. You see, I have two leftover corks, and to show them flying away, I used some Copics in gray again. And if you have a better idea to do this, please tell me in the comments. I made kind of this card before, and was not didn't regret to use the Copics for this. But if you have a good idea, I would love to know it. And for finish my card, I really tried to put glossy accent over all these bottles. And can you see my glossy accent bottle is smaller than one of these bottles on the card. But it was enough. Yes, then thanks for listening to my Scatman English. And thanks for watching. And bye bye.